Today's story is about Jonah and God. This story is in the first part of the Bible, which is called the Old Testament. This is before Jesus was born. It was about a man called Jonah. Jonah was a prophet. This means that he hears messages from God. God has chosen to tell him things that he wanted him to share with the people that he lived with. And the people trusted Jonah and listened to all of the messages that he had to tell them. One day, God spoke to Jonah with a new message. And this is what it said. Jonah, I want you to go to the neighbouring town of Nineveh. The people who live in Nineveh are always showing broken love to each other, and I need them to stop. I would like you to go and spend some time with the people and teach them about the right way to live so that they stop breaking love and they start to show love to each other again. Now, Jonah loved God very much and he always wanted to do as God asked him. But the people of Nineveh scared him because they showed broken love all of the time. Jonah was worried that they would show broken love to him as well. Now, Jonah really wanted just to stay at home in the town that he lived in Israel, with the people that loved God and they did their best to not break love. He really just wanted to keep doing the things that he always did and stay with them and be God's messenger. So Jonah decided not to listen to God and not go. But then he became worried that God would ask him again, so Jonah decided that he needed to run away. So Jonah left the town of Israel and he made his way all the way through the land until he reached the sea. And when he got to the edge of the sea, Jonah met some men who were just about to set sail in their boat. And they kindly said that Jonah could go with them. Jonah was very grateful because this meant that he could get as far away from God as possible and hopefully God would not be able to find him. So they set sail together in the boat. When they reached the middle of the sea, a storm started to come and there was waves that were crashing up over the boat and it became very, very scary. Jonah prayed to God for it to stop, but nothing happened. Jonah then realised that this meant that God was in control of the storm and that God was trying to get Jonah's attention. The storm continued and the boat was rocking wildly and all of the men were really scared. Jonah told them that he thought that God was trying to get his attention and that if they threw him off the side of the boat, that the storm would stop. The men were unsure, but they did as Jonah said, and they did throw him off of the boat. Oh my goodness, poor Jonah. Now Jonah was in the sea and he was all alone and scared. Then all of a sudden something amazing happened and a big fish came along and swallowed Jonah whole. Jonah didn't realise what had happened to him. Jonah was inside the fish's tummy. Inside it was dark and wet and smelly. But the fish didn't eat Jonah. Jonah stayed inside for 3 days and for 3 nights. This was a long time. Whilst Jonah was inside the fish, he felt really close to God. Jonah spent time talking to God, and he knew that God was looking after him and keeping him safe all of the time. After 3 days, the fish arrived at the shore, and he spat Jonah back on to the land. Then God spoke to Jonah again, and he said, "Jonah, I want you to go to the land of Nineveh, and I want you to speak to all of the people that are showing broken love." This time, Jonah listened to God. And when he reached the land of Nineveh, it wasn't how he expected it to be. Jonah told all of the people about the story, about how the big fish had swallowed him up, and he had spent 3 whole days and 3 whole nights inside the fish's tummy, and how God had looked after him, and how he wasn't alone, and he felt really, really close to God. The people of Nineveh were amazed to hear Jonah's story and about how God looked after him in this way, that they decided to change their ways, and they began to show love to each other, and they began to show love to God. So this story helps us think about a few things. I wonder if there's anything in your life that you are running away from. Maybe something that you are doing that you shouldn't be doing. Maybe there's something that you need to do and you're scared about doing that. But actually, when you choose to do it, it'll be easier than you expected it to be. I wonder if you felt all alone, just like the time that Jonah was inside the fish's tummy. And I wonder if you talked to God and asked him to be close to you, that he would help you to feel safe and that you would feel close to him, just like Jonah did. The last part of God's big story reminds us that God is always here to help us. We just need to remember to talk to him and ask him for his help, and his superpower can come and help us just the same way as it helped Jonah.